Hey guys, welcome back. In this episode I am going to do some quick checks on my Volvo V70. I own this car since a week and I started getting more feelings about the state of this moose. The engine is running smooth, cold starts no problem, even at minus degrees, some squeaking noises coming from the right wheel, I guess something is wrong with the bushings or the shock absorber strut mounts, the transmission is shifting a little bit hard, especially when the fluid is over 16 degrees Celsius. The codes that I mentioned on the first video about the accelerator pedal and the transmission are still there, even after I deleted them. They came back again. This means I have to find the issues and fix them. But before digging on the faulty codes problem, I want to do some deeper checks to get an accurate feeling about the state of this car. The first thing I want to do is the compression test, of course, to see how healthy this engine is. So let's jump into it. I started removing the engine covers. Here I wanted to check if the PCV valve is doing its job. There should be a vacuum inside the valve cover.
See, the PCV is working, so I think we're good.
Well, seems to be working. As I got an access to see the timing belt, I had a look at it.
I'm checking now the timing belt. I'm going to change it anyway, but it starts getting some cracks on it, so I think it's a very good time to change it.
It should be done anyway. Unscrewing the 10mm screws of the coils. Before disconnecting the coils, I labeled the connectors.
So you break them.
Everything looks nice and clean around the spark plugs. No oil leakages. Now removing the spark plugs, some of them were too tight. I think they had been there for a long time. All the spark plugs look fine, no oil, no signs of bad combustion, no carbons. This is a nice light brown color, and this is what you should expect in a good engine. I measured the gap spacing and I found values around 1mm, which is a lot. This is a confirmation that these spark plugs were there for too long. Now, the moment of truth, measuring the compression of the first cylinder. Around 12 bars, which is good. Now the second cylinder.
What?
Around 7 bars, which is too low. This shocked me, of course, but I double checked it with another try.
No.
I had a doubt about the thread of the spark plugs on the cylinder head, but it was okay. The second try was even worse, 6 bars.
This is not good.
Then I move it to the third cylinder and so on.
Here, almost 13. Yeah, 0. I think there is a problem with the thread of the spark plug. So I'm going to check cylinder number 5. That is actually good, no traces of aluminium.
And 4 bars on the cylinder number 5. This is the second try.
Oh my God. Now I am going to add some engine oil to cylinder number 2 and see if the compression gets better. Same value. So I think the warrant is not coming from the piston rings, but is coming from the head gasket, or it is coming from the, did you see the value? Same value as before. Well, I think, as I said, it is coming not from the piston rings, but it is coming from the top, from the valves, or from the head gasket. I have to look for this for the problem. I'm going to do the same for the cylinder number 5. Do you see that? Almost 4.2 or 0.5.
And here are the results. Totally shocking values on cylinder number 2 and 5. I can't believe this. The engine is running like butter, no misfires and no shaking. Very weird. But I had a look with the endoscope inside the engine. This is the cylinder number 2. As you can see, a lot of burnt oil and carbons. Maybe this is preventing the valves to close properly? I don't know. This is the cylinder number 2. The valves with the carbons are the intake ones. The other valves are the exhaust valves. But honestly, I couldn't see everything with my crappy endoscope because maybe the valve seats are burned, and this could be confirmed only by taking off the cylinder head. This is the cylinder number 5. A leak test on the cylinders could help identify the problem from the valves, but I don't have this tool for this. I had a look inside all the cylinders and all of them looks the same with the carbons inside them. No scratches on the cylinder walls and no visible damages on the pistons or on the valves. Even with the scan tool, there is no misfire at all. The engine is running properly and absolutely no noticeable issues and no vibrations. Well, let's forget about the compression right now and move to something else. Here I am checking the catalytic converter from the inside with my endoscope. Absolutely no visible damages and no carbon buildups. But for the catalytic converter and the oxygen sensor, I will do another separate video. I checked the transmission fluid, I took the dipstick out, and no wonder that this car is shifting very bad.
It's completely dry. There is no oil at all. Just one spot here. Just one spot at the end of the dipstick.
I performed the leak test on the cooling circuit using my pressure test kit. It maintains the pressure and no leaks. You may have noticed that the exhaust is a bit loud. Here is the problem. There is a small hole between the exhaust pipe and the muffler. This should be fixed for the MOT. After a couple of days driving the car, I noticed this problem too. The heater core is leaking inside the car. It could be just the gaskets, or the hose, or the whole core unit should be changed. But luckily, the heater is not buried under the dashboard. Coming to the suspension, and this is the squeaking noise that I'm talking about. The shock absorbers strut mounts are totally shot. The sway bar links are also kaput. Well guys, what do you think? Is it disappointing? Bad compression in two cylinders? What would you do if you have this car? You gonna sell it or send it to the crusher? Honestly, I am a bit sad about the results of the compression test, but I still have some doubts about my measures because, as you saw it, the values are fluctuating and not stable. For sure, I will repeat the test in a correct way. With the throttle body wide open and with a fully charged battery, maybe I will use another compression tester. We'll see. I already made up my mind and I have a plan how to go on. But for sure, I will keep this car for a while and try to get the technical inspection. See you next time and tschüss.